Man, I hope your boy's been good since that last video. I'ma try my hardest on here, bro, because y'all gotta understand I'm running a full-time channel. It's Davian Omar, bro. It's a whole bunch of food videos. It's nothing really that important when it comes to talking about self-love, self-care, taking care of yourself and everything like that. I do talk about shit like that on there, but that video is more for like entertainment side. This channel is more for like me. Honestly, bro, I don't care if I get zero video views. I don't care if I get zero monthly gain subscribers, bro. I want to post on this channel once a month. No, not once a month, but once every week for myself, man. Y'all gotta understand, man, like, the higher you go spiritually, man, the harder it gets, man. Like, you gonna need something to open up to, somebody to open up to. They might not respond. Like, for instance, like, you might post like 100 videos within 6 months, and like out of them 100 videos, probably like 20 videos only get comments from people that's actually giving you feedback and stuff. What I'm saying is, them other 80 videos, people feel what you're saying, people know what you're going through, people understand, they connect with you. But because they don't comment, don't think nobody connects with you, don't think nobody really mess with you, you know what I'm saying? So get that concept out your head, bro. You just gotta realize this is just something you have to go through alone, you know what I'm saying? And people's gonna be with you, people that watch, look up to you, watch you, either if it's on Instagram, whatever social media you prefer posting on. People is always watching you. People always pray. I call praising you behind closed doors. Number one, you shouldn't want nobody to praise you. So that shouldn't be your attention. That shouldn't even be your first thought, is having somebody praise you. You should be strictly focusing on trying to better and love yourself to the fullest ability that you possibly can as a human being. You know what I'm saying? Second of all, if you're helping somebody and you know you're helping somebody, keep doing it. Why are you letting all these bots and all these people that will never, ever walk a mile, not even a couple inches in your shoes, tell you how you should go about things or how you should do things? Stop it, bro. They can't walk a mile in your shoes, G. They can't post 6 videos a week. They can't work a full-time job at the same time and take care of all their family, make sure their family's straight. They can't do what you're doing. So get that concept out your head that you gotta impress these people that's not doing shit but sitting in their bed all day and looking at the sky and looking at the wall. Don't let nobody tell you what to do, bro. End of the day, I'm only saying this shit so I know a lot of people that can relate to me. If you can't relate to me, then relate to me on this. Life is hard, bro. For everybody. Look at anybody. Walk down the street and look at a nigga sitting on his porch smoking a cigarette. Walk down the other street and you see a nigga just hopped in his car and look at all happy playing his music. I guarantee them two people go through shit just like you. It's nobody on this earth that's not going through suffering and pain, bro. And the people that go through suffering and pain the most is the people that's going to be the greatest, that's going to have the greatest outcome on this earth. I swear to God. They either going to influence people, they either going to do good for people, they either going to motivate people, they're going to do something that's good, my nigga. If you not going through a lot of shit, like ever in your life, since you was little, since now, wherever you at, it's because, bro, it's just specific chosen few that goes through the most shit. And that's a fact, bro. And I definitely agree to above and beyond. I am one of them. I would never come on here complain about anything. I would tell you to keep pushing, keep going, nigga, because that's what I want you to do. I'm not going to say no shit that's like, well, since I'm going through this, I want you to do this. Like, no, it's the same message every single time. I am a very good thinker, right? You have to realize, bro, your best friend, the nigga next to you, everybody around you goes through the same shit. Your mama, your daddy goes through the same shit. Same shit as what, Omar? They all go through shit. You have to realize when it's gonna be time for you to live life for you. and stop trying to live for everybody else, bro. This living for everybody else shit is a fucking illusion, my nigga. I don't give a fuck what nobody think, nigga. I got my crystals on. I got my chain on. Nigga, I don't care what nobody thinks. It's because, bro, when you really tap in with yourself, you realize you only have really got your fucking self. Everybody got somebody. Omar has nobody. You have to really understand me. Everybody has somebody, but Omar has nobody. That's nobody I could just call. Y'all have that. So be grateful, bro. You don't want to be this great, my nigga. You don't want to be on this level of thinking. You don't want to be this woke. You don't want to be a great fucking guy. Because a loneliness is the lifestyle. You don't have consistently one person that you talk to all the time. It's probably multiple people. You're probably always fucking confused. Why do blah, blah, blah move like that? Oh, why do blah, blah, blah move like that? It's because they have nobody. You do. Being a real chosen one. I mean, real chosen one as in like being a one-on-one of chosen ones. Anybody can be a chosen one. Even you sleep right now, my nigga, you could wake up one day. You realize your life is not what it seems, and you could change your life all the way around, and you're considered a chosen one because you're woke to the situation. But it's one-on-ones, chosen ones, and they go through the most bullshit. They go through the most bullshit, and they always have the best outcome of everything they really put their soul and work in. It's because we're not lucky. We are blessed. We all blessed to be breathing. If you're still breathing, my nigga, you're blessed. Don't throw that past your head. We're not lucky, though. We're not lucky. I think it's just that we just got infinite gratitude and infinite gratefulness. You know what I'm saying? Gratitude. Like, we got heavy gratitude. We always have heavy respect. No matter what we're going through, we never put our problems on anybody else. That's the beauty of the one-on-one chosen ones. And how many one-on-one chosen ones is there? It's unknown. You know what I'm saying? You just know when you see one. You know when you spot one. You know, oh, like, who is that? I never felt this type of, or I ain't never felt this type of energy. Oh, hold on. Like, who was that? You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, hold on, this dude different. Like, it's just you, bro. You have to focus on yourself. Everybody deep down inside is a chosen one. It's this illusion, this matrix they put us in that draws you far away, way more far away from your inner self, your true self, my nigga. You got to find the odds. Everything's an illusion. From worshiping females. I love my females. I love all my females. If it wasn't for a lot of these females on this earth, you wouldn't have the one-on-one chosen ones that's here today. So I'm not discouraging my females for niggas that think I'm about to right now when I say this. Females. That's program, you know what I'm saying? Worshiping females back in the day. They always fight over females. They always did that. But females always wasn't never our main priority. Our main priority was doing what we love doing and taking care of our family, of course. So our main priority was our purpose. And then it was just our wife, you know what I'm saying? It's just the priorities fucked up now. They telling you all to prioritize your females, to put your purpose second. But you notice that everybody that does that, they never truly have the outcome that they really want to have. It's because you're getting brainwashed to think that, oh, well, I seen on TikTok, he worship pussy more than his lifestyle, so I'ma do that too. And that's where you fuck up at. You have to go deep down in your consciousness and go by what yourself tell you. You have to start meditating. You have to start taking care of yourself. You have to start eating better. You have to start getting nature. I've been in nature for about to be 2 hours now. You have to start doing these things, bro. First of all, if you on step one right now, I recommend you to be isolated immediately, as soon as possible. You at your friend's house right now watching this video, go home, my nigga. And you know, first thing I want you to do is you take care of yourself. Which means you take care of yourself. You just got home, right? So throw your clothes in the washer. Okay. Go get you something to eat. Go go take a shower. My fault, man. I got kind of tight. My shit had overheated. Let me go over here and show you then. So I won't overheat again. So, what you need to do next, you need to meditate. I'm going this shot. They over here talking. I don't want no background noise for the video. I only want y'all to hear the sun god or more. You know what I'm saying? So, what you do next? You meditate. It's a lot of shit over here. This is why they won't come over. Close this door. I'm at Big Bro House. Y'all probably think Omar got hella cribs. Nah, bro, I'm at Big Bro House. I'm gonna go right here in the sun a little bit. I ain't gonna be here too long. I want my shit to overheat again. What I need y'all to do is, bro, meditate, nigga, for a minute. If you knew at this, meditate for 1 minute. I promise you, bro, you're just, don't think about anything. Matter of fact, you can't think about anything. How do you meditate? Let me tell you right now how to meditate, a little God. You breathe in as heavy as possible, and you exhale. What's exhale, Omar? You breathe out as hard as possible. Don't do it to where your lungs start hurting. Do it as smooth, but do it as deep as possible. And you should feel your blood rushing, your everything rushing. You know what I'm saying? This is how you meditate. Y'all need to start doing this. If you're a starter, like I said, I don't care who you're around right now. Go to the crib right now. Your mama house, if you got your own house. I don't care what your situation is, bro. You're homeless. I don't care. You're in jail. I don't care. You could do this today, right now. 099, my nigga. Go to your cell. Go to your house. Your crib. Wherever you at. The tent. Wherever you at, my nigga. Meditate for 1 minute. If you never did this before, meditate for 1 minute. What you gonna do is, you gonna sit down in a comfortable position on the floor. And what you gonna do next? What I'm gonna do next, Omar? Let me tell you. You gonna put your fingers together like this. Or you put your hands together like this. All your fingers spread out. You gonna exhale. You gonna inhale, then exhale. Repeatedly do it for that whole minute. And watch how fast your mood changes, my nigga. So that's what I'm just trying to tell y'all, bro. You have to connect with yourself. You want more for yourself. You want to become successful, right? You want to become a better person, right? You want to be able to take care of your family, right? You have to do more for yourself. All y'all think about is doing and doing for other people. That's not going to make you a better person. It's going to make people use you. You're nothing to them. You're just a money machine to them, my nigga. Or however you give it to them. However you give them the currency, attention, whatever. You're just that currency to them. You would never be nothing more than them to that. So stop doing that shit. First of all, cut off all the funny shit. You got funny ass friends. You got bootleg ass friends. You got niggas that, swear to God, they got shit going on, but still in the same position. Cut them niggas off right now, today. They're nothing to you. Promise you. You won't, bro. Talk to them niggas again in like 2 years. They're doing the same shit. Still in the video game all day, not doing shit. What the other nigga doing? Oh, he swear to God, he's still doing whatever he had got going on, but he ain't making no progress. He's not growing. It's because niggas not taking this shit serious. You need niggas around you as hustlers, bro. And as a spiritual nigga, being a hustler don't mean nothing to your spiritual growth. It just ups. It just ups you. You're doing. If you're around hustlers all day, nigga, you're going to become a hustler. And you need to become a hustler so you can become financially free, my nigga. All this shit, like I said, all this shit is connected, my nigga. You need to be a hustler so you can become financially free. So you can have a big-ass house with a big-ass backyard like this. And you could be, bro, my nigga, you could be back here all day. On your off days, all shit. You only hustle half that day on that Saturday. The other half, nigga, you gonna be in the back, chilling, connecting with yourself. Or you got a family, you out here playing with your kids. This telling you, all this shit is connected. Everybody tell you to sit still, you do this sit still when you first become spiritual. It's because, my nigga, you have to find yourself and you gotta know what the fuck you want. If you don't know what you want, none of this shit matter. None of this shit matter. If you don't know what you truly want, none of this matter. Not even yourself. You have to know what you want, my nigga. You can't be chasing after nothing. That's all these drug dealers and that's 90% of these drug dealers is doing and 90% of these niggas is working jobs is doing. They're chasing, bro, they're in an endless circle. All they keep saying, I'm getting money. But how long, my nigga? You gonna do this shit forever? You gonna sell drugs forever? You gonna work this 9-to-5 job forever? How long? They can't even tell you how long, my nigga, because they don't even know. As soon as they get the money, it's gone. They're blowing it. They're not putting them no coins. They're not putting in no trust funds. They're not stacking up nothing. These niggas is, bro, you're moving blind. And none of this shit is about money, bro. This is about, I'm telling you, like the real, bro, about yourself, my nigga. Cause 95, like 9 times out of 10, my nigga, if you're not focusing on yourself, you're not taking care of yourself. You don't have no money. So this is why this shit all back circle around again. Y'all too worried about your financial life. Y'all too worried about your life, my nigga. Take the wheel back, bro, for whatever the fuck is controlling you, that demonic dark ass energy. Take the wheel back from that shit. That's step one. And get in your own lane. Right now you're in the fast lane right now, my nigga. Get into your own lane. Hop in your own lane. Get your own thing cracking. Get whatever you want doing. Put yourself a saving goal. Get yourself a saving goal and say, I want, in 6 months, I want $10,000. Keep manifesting it. Wake up every day. Sleep, piss, dream. Dream this shit. Eat this shit. I want $10,000 in my bank account in 6 months. That's simple. Or you could do a year. You know what I'm saying? However you want to do it, just be like, I want $10,000. $10,000. Manifest the shit. Keep telling yourself that. When everybody's all like, what the fuck is he talking about? That $10,000 hit your bank account. The niggas that's laughing, they got their hand out. They want something now. Because you manifested, you saved it up. You did that shit, nigga. Nobody else. You saved that shit. And you have to start becoming selfish, my nigga. A lot of y'all niggas is too fucking givey. It's too fucking givey to niggas that you're not obligated to take care of, like your girlfriends and boyfriends. Y'all not obligated to do shit for them. Stop. Especially if it's hurting you. If you got a little dime and you know you're gonna have a little money for the next couple weeks, go ahead and do that. But if you know you ain't gonna have shit, stop. You're not obligated to take care of this motherfucker. You're not. That same thing for my females too. I'm not just talking to my guys. I'm talking to all y'all. You're not obligated to take care of that nigga, baby. Like, if you know they're gonna give it back, that's something different. But still though, bro, you gotta tell them to get on their shit, bro. You too damn old, or you just, bro, come on, bro. It's a lot could go into about relationships and shit, like things I never do, but that's gonna be in a whole other video. I might make that video right after this one. I'm not lying to you. But yeah, bro, y'all niggas need to stop doing a lot of shit, bro. You're not obligated to take care of nobody but your family, bro. Well, looking out for your family. You know, bro, I'm gonna be real with you. You're not even obligated to take care of your family, G. But if you're a real one, you got a heart, bro, you gonna take care of your family. You gonna make sure your sister straight, your bro straight. You gonna make sure your parents straight. You know what I'm saying? You gonna make sure whoever straight. Cousin need a little stack. I got you. I throw you a few blues. You know what I'm saying? Like, you only could do that shit when you on your shit. But if you sitting around here, y'all all looking at each other stupid, like, oh shit, we all broke, we all fucked up, because y'all all blowing your money. Y'all all not saving nothing. Y'all all not putting, y'all all not investing into nothing. Y'all all don't got shit going on. Nigga, y'all running on the hamster wheels. Like I said in one of my videos, it's too much hamsters on that wheel. G, you need to knock some of them the fuck off. You need to knock off them Hulu subscriptions, the Pornhub subscriptions. It's a lot of shit y'all niggas need to knock off. Yeah, that y'all don't need. What the fuck are you sitting around here watching Hulu for? Nigga, you supposed to be outside grinding. You supposed to be doing DoorDash. You supposed to be doing whatever. Get your bag up. I don't want to hear. I don't got no job. 90% of y'all niggas be screaming. Y'all ain't got no job, but y'all got a car, nigga. I don't want to be out here DoorDashing. Bro, they literally made it easy for you to hustle the legal way to get a dollar every second of the day, my nigga. And y'all niggas sitting here still looking at me. Y'all still on this video? Slap yourself, my nigga. You need to wake up. You know what I'm saying? But that pretty much says it, man. I'm about to be talking about a whole bunch of nothing. I could get into this shit all day. Y'all look out for that things I never do in a relationship video. It's gonna be very touchy. It's gonna hit a lot of people because I'm not blind to shit. Man, Davian Omar signing out. Hey, love y'all, man. Aisha Omar. Yeah.